My name is Anna Lusardi, and I am delighted about the release of the third wave of the PISA financial literacy data. This is very important data, and it provides another piece of information that can guide policy and programs directed at high school students. I'm honored to have chaired the group of experts who designed the first PISA financial literacy assessment. From our very first meeting in Boston more than 10 years ago, it was clear to all of us that we had been given a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. With our work, we could contribute to the advancement of research and policy related to youth financial literacy. Of all the projects I've done, the work on the PISA financial literacy assessment is my favorite. It has been the most difficult, but also the most rewarding. It is not easy to design questions that measure financial literacy among 15 years old students who live in different countries around the world. But with this work, I felt, as did the other experts, that we were laying down a foundation, the first brick for the construction of a set of database policies for financial education in school. I want to mention the definition of financial literacy that we came up with and on which the first PISA assessment was based. Here it is. Financial literacy is knowledge and understanding of financial concepts and risks and the skills, motivation, and confidence to apply such knowledge and understanding in order to make effective decisions across a range of financial contexts to improve the financial well-being of individuals and society and to enable participation in economic life. Many years later, not only is this definition still valid and going strong, but it reminds us that knowledge is power. Knowledge empowers people to make good decisions, not only for themselves, but for society as well. Knowledge enables young people to participate in economic life. In the past, if people were not able to read and write, they could not fully participate in society. Today, we also need to be financially literate. The data has given us many important insights. First, in every country that have participated in the assessment, there is a group of young people who do not have the basic financial knowledge that will enable them to participate in society. This tells us that we all need to do better. Second, even rich countries with well-developed financial markets have many students who do not score well on financial literacy. This tells us that students do not learn simply by watching the world around them. Third, socioeconomic background is a critical determinant of financial literacy. It is students from rich, resourceful, and well-educated families that have higher financial literacy. This tells us that inequality in financial literacy starts early. These data tell us that it is time to step up the effort to improve financial literacy among the young. The costs of not doing so are dire. Not only will some of our young people be left behind, but we will continue to perpetuate an unequal society. The pandemic caused by the coronavirus that we are all experiencing has further demonstrated how critically important these basic skills are. It is during a storm that sailing lessons show their worth. This crisis has shown us how critically important it is to be financially literate so we can all build financial resilience. More than ever, financial literacy is an essential skill. We can all contribute to improving financial literacy among the young, to promoting financial education in school. As director of the Financial Education Committee in Italy, you can be sure that we will use the findings of the third wave of the PISA data to inform our work in Italy. And I hope that all of the countries that participated in the PISA assessment will do the same. It takes a visionary leader to promote financial education. Education is an investment for the future, and one needs to look into the future to undertake such a project. The OECD is and continue to be that visionary leader that is guiding us to focus on the youth. We should. They are our future. I want to thank the extraordinary team at the OECD who have worked on PISA and the PISA Financial Literacy Assessment, and in particular, Andrea Schleicher and Florent Messi. And thank you for allowing me to be part of it. Working on this project has convinced me even more of the importance of financial literacy. It is like water in an ecosystem. We all need it to do well. It's not sustainable to have so little of it and to have it distributed so unequally. Let's make sure in particular that our youth have plenty of it so they can grow and flourish.